Hello, you're watching the Crypto Roundup. Joining me with all that's been happening in the world of crypto this week is Proactive's Billy Farrington. Billy, very good to speak with you again.
And you, Stephen, always a pleasure. How's it going?
It's going well. And looks like it's been going well for Bitcoin as the week draws to a close. A fair bit on the macroeconomic agenda this week. How did Bitcoin respond, Billy?
Yeah, it was quite an interesting one on the macro calendar this week. Obviously, in the middle of the week, we saw the US inflation print come in slightly hotter than expected, like 0.1% hotter than the market had forecast. But despite that kind of incremental increase to the expected inflation print, the markets took a bit of a whacking in the immediate aftermath as the market started to price in potentially fewer, you know, interest rate reductions as the year in the year ahead. So yeah, Bitcoin took an immediate tumble following that inflation print. But to me, there are some real signs of stability in the market, because immediately following that dip, the bulls jumped in, took advantage of the cheaper prices, and managed to send the Bitcoin dollar pair back higher. So there was a quite quick recovery from that intraday dip following that hot inflation print, slightly hot inflation print. As the week drew to a close, things sort of stabilized. And we're actually looking, we're actually in the green week on week by about 6.5%. So ultimately, like a strong trading week for Bitcoin, despite that midweek volatility. Bitcoin's been supported by strong ETF inflows as well. It's about, the last couple of days we saw about $230 million of cash inflows into the ETF market, which has undoubtedly helped support Bitcoin's price as well. So yeah, for me, the narrative this week is stability in the face of volatility against some, worse than expected macroeconomic data. But all in all, not a bad week for Bitcoin.
We've got gold at an all-time high of around $2,400 an ounce. Does this mean Bitcoin will also reach an all-time high shortly?
Yeah, people like to call Bitcoin the digital gold, and rightfully so. It has sort of similar aspects in terms of scarcity and these sorts of things. But I think we need to remember that the fundamentals are quite different. Now, gold is at these stellar all-time highs because central banks, the likes of China and India, are buying physical gold by the boatload. I mean, like a lot of these gold, this gold price right now, a lot of these gold purchases are physical as opposed to ETFs. So it's, the actual central banks actually increasing their reserves. I don't like to say it's because of the whole de-dollarization trend, because I think de-dollarization is sort of a load of bollocks that people like to bandy the word around. It doesn't really mean anything. But nonetheless, though, central banks are buying a lot of gold, as a hedge against, volatility. I guess we don't really know where monetary policy is heading this year, and gold, is a little bit of a safety net for people, for investors, and for sovereign entities as well. So that's kind of what has been driving gold's, really strong price at the moment. Whereas, Bitcoin, the fundamentals are a bit different. It's more like a mix of, these incredibly strong ETF inflows that we've seen since January, the upcoming halving event later this month as well, and just a general recovery from extremely low Bitcoin prices that we've seen in the last couple of years. So yeah, different fundamentals. However, to get back to your question, can Bitcoin reclaim its all-time high? It absolutely can. It's not that far off. So I hit the all-time high in mid-March, last month, and we're about $3,000 off that all-time high right now, which is not, given the fact that, Bitcoin is such a volatile asset and it can swing, 10% up or down, day on day. Absolutely, it can reach that all-time high. I wouldn't be surprised if we see a fresh all-time high, in the coming days or weeks. So obviously, no crystal ball and all that, but I'm saying it's definitely not, outside the realm of possibility. So I'll be keeping my eye on how momentum goes over the coming days to see if we can achieve that upper $73,000 all-time high that we saw about a month ago.
Anything else in the crypto world that captured headlines this week, Billy?
Well, remember when Sam Bankman-Fried got given 25 years a few weeks ago for mass fraud, money laundering, wire fraud and all those tasty things as the head of FTX. You know, he's behind bars for 25 years. Well, we just learned that he has appealed that sentence. So maybe not so unexpected, but I think it's funny that he maintains his sort of innocence, really. You know, he's always apologized for losing, you know, these billions upon billions of customers' funds, but he's never actually, you know, he's never actually sort of put his hands up and said, yeah, I'm a fraudster or whatnot. So for me, this appeal, not so unexpected, but should be quite interesting to see what the lawyers say, what his defense, because the defense counsel hasn't actually sort of said on what basis the appeal is on yet. So I look forward to hearing what their sort of justifications for this appeal is. But yeah, he's just filed the appeal before the New York courts. So that should be interesting to see how that plays out. The judge might just throw it out the window and move on with their day.
Well, we'll be watching that along with that Bitcoin touching those new highs there. Billy, have a great weekend. Thanks for your input again.
You too. All the best.
Yeah. That's Proactive's Billy Farrington.